Right now, I'm not writing this just to tell a scary story. I'm fucking scared shitless and I need somewhere to vent. It is currently 1:07 a.m. and I'm typing this from my phone under my covers. I'm uncomfortable and hot, but there's no way I'm leaving the safety of my sheets. Let me give you a little background information. Hopefully this will distract me. I've had nightmares my entire life. They've never been anything significant. Just the common ones that you get after watching a scary movie or hear a frightening campfire story. I've always been gullible to that kind of stuff. Yeah. I was a kid that always ran to my parents' room whenever I had a bad dream. It's never really been a problem. Recently, though, my nightmares have been getting worse. It's been about a month since these bad dreams started. I don't want to sound cliché, but it definitely started after my family moved into our new house. The house seemed normal when we moved in, and it still seems normal now. The only strange things that happened occur in my dreams. God, I don't know why I thought this was a good idea. I'm sweating like a goddamn pig under these sheets, and my nightmare is all I can think about. So, anyway, like I said, these bad dreams have changed a bit since we moved in. For example, in one of the dreams, I remember I killed an entire family. It was like I was watching from someone else's eyes. I didn't know who the people were. I was just walking around in a house shooting the fucking brains out of the family as they slept. That one fucked me up a bit. I never told my parents about these nightmares. My sister has been going through a rough patch and my parents are busy enough keeping her from harming herself. It's been mentally taxing for all of us. I wasn't about to add more stress onto everyone just to complain about my weird dreams. Sorry to get personal, but I'm not exactly worried about that at the moment. So, I kept the nightmares to myself. After tonight, though, I'll probably bring it up. I guess I'll get to the part that's freaking the hell out of me. I've been staying up really late the past few nights. Usually, if I do that, then I forget my dreams and the night goes by quickly. Last night I went to bed early. Today's going to be my first day working at my new job, and I was sick of feeling tired all the time. I went to bed around 8 p.m. I woke up during the night. After laying in my bed for a bit, I started to notice weird things. Like the fact that my room looked different. Just little things, like the furniture had been moved around. But it was definitely my room. Slowly, I began to realize that I was still dreaming. Everything just felt so surreal. As I was thinking, realizing that I was totally dreaming, I noticed that the light in my closet was on. It's a walk-in, which I wasn't that used to. I remembered my mom talking about getting new light for it because the one that was in there had burned out, so it was weird that the light would be on. Something inside me was telling me to get up and turn the light off. That's exactly what I did. Okay, before you start thinking that I'm totally mental, just remember that I was dreaming. No one thinks right when they're dreaming. So I got out of bed and went to turn off the light. The light switch is on the inside of the closet, so I opened the door. Fuck, just thinking about it gives me chills. There was a boy standing in my closet. I can't tell you how old or any details, because all I saw was the back of his head before I fell back on my ass. My head still hurt from the fear that jolted through me. Then I woke up. Again. I was sweating and my head hurt. It was weird because I had never felt actual pain in my dreams before, but my whole body was aching from the fear. I was panicky and I just remember it being really dark. The quiet was almost unbearable. I remember reaching over to get my phone, but it wasn't there, which confused me. I always had my phone. I panicked again and looked around my room. Everything was where it should have been, except for one thing. The boy was sitting on the end of my bed, facing away from me. Once again, I woke up, and there I am now, feeling like I'm going to shit my pants. No nightmare has made me this scared before. I really just need to let this all out. Oh, fuck, I'm scared out of my mind. Don't have the courage to get up and run to my parents' room like I used to. My head still hurts and my heart is beating 100 miles a minute, but not because of my false awakenings. The light in my closet is on.